position and guns at the ready, each hunter begins to move deliberately yet slowly through a cornfield. The rattling of the corn stalks as they walk only increases the hunter's anxious anticipation, for each hunter knows that at any moment, the crisp winter air could explode with the cackling fury of a ringneck pheasant exploding from cover. The drivers maintain a slight cup formation and keep a distance between one another to only a few yards. They know only too well that the crafty ringneck rooster can slither like a fox from corn row to corn row and between widely spaced drivers, doubling back between them. The blockers positioned at each corner of the opposite end of the field watch the slow advance intently, while still paying close attention to the edge of cover between them. Their presence is to stop a rooster that may be running ahead of the drivers. Each driver walks a short distance zigzagging through the rows of corn, then pauses momentarily. This pause is often all it takes to unnerve a tightly holding rooster. And the drivers hold their position as the bird is quickly retrieved. As much real estate as possible should be covered. There could be another bird near another driver, and no one for safety's sake should be out in front in the possible field of fire. Bird in the bag, and the drive is now continued into the wind. This tactic tends to put the birds up and away from the line of drivers and offers pass shooting to our outside driver. Our young hunter has a disadvantage because of his height. Having difficulty seeing and being seen, he is placed on the outside of the field near the watchful eye of his father. What our young hunter lacks in size, he makes up for in shooting ability. Clearly a shot to be proud of. For the young or old, the ringneck pheasant rooster is a very difficult target. A driver near the edge hears a bird running ahead of him. He signals the blocker nearest him. To get a better view of the side of the field, he backs up a few feet and readies. Drivers all stop as the bird is retrieved because the blocker has moved into the line of fire. The handsome rooster bagged, and the drivers again move out. In good pheasant country, it is not uncommon to see two or more birds flush at the same time. It's equally common for a multi-bird flush to cause multi-hunter confusion about proper sex. Who's drawing down on which bird and keeping safety in mind?
Can you believe that shot?
Set the brakes.
The pheasant drive is a very common yet effective means to bag the crafty ringneck pheasant and an opportunity to share with friends the excitement and fulfillment of the hunt. The ringneck pheasant is one of the most difficult and challenging of American game birds to hunt. Equipped with short-cupped wings, once airborne, he can accelerate rapidly to speeds of up to 50 miles per hour. But his forte is to run, and run he does. Once he detects danger, this fleet-footed bird can outdistance man and dog in a matter of seconds. And now, mix the ingredients of man, well-trained dog, and elusive ringneck pheasant, and witness the ultimate upland game bird challenge.
Okay, call it.
Heads. All right, heads it is, my man.
How about the best two out of three?
Oh, no, you don't. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take that field over there to my left. That looks good to me.
I don't think that's a good idea, John.
No, why is that?
Well, look how thick this cover is. You're going to work all the way over to that vagrant cornfield and that heavy cover with that pointer. He's going to bump birds, run into hot scent, and push birds clear out of gun range, end up back here at the vehicle with severe brain damage.
No, 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 not me and my jet. I know why you want that field. This way you and your lab are guaranteed not to get lost.
Not likely.
No, no, no. Why is that? Look, even with that lab at your feet, and even if you do happen to look out and hit a pheasant, okay, you're going to have to go over there and spray it with duck scent. This way you don't have to worry about him finding it, okay? You know how to treat old gunner right. Me and jet's okay.
Okay. Duck scent, huh? Mm-hmm. Look out and hit a pheasant, huh? Okay, I'll tell you what I'll do. The first guy that gets his limit, all right, or the most birds, and ends up back here at the vehicle, gets dinner bought for him. His choice of restaurant.
You got a deal. I'll tell you what we'll do. See the south side of that fence?
Right.
We'll meet down here right by those willows after the hunt is done.
Okay.
And dinner will be on you.
Sounds good. Oh, hey, by the way, you do have permission to hunt in that property.
I do have permission, and do you have permission to hunt with that Labrador?
Bye now.
Okay, Jed, let's show them how it's done. The wind is a little out of the northwest, so I'll take an angle more northerly and let him make his passes into the wind. I guess I'm about halfway between the edge and the center. This should allow him to block the center sweep back the other way and cover the edge. There's definitely some tough cover in here. I'll slow up a bit and give him time to work this. Besides, any rooster that was hanging around in the field is either running ahead or for that cover along the fence row. Now, if I keep zigzagging into it and then away, they're going to have a tough time figuring out my course and knowing which way is the safest way to run. He's on a scent. Okay, easy does it, boy. Just take your time and work it out. Okay, steady, boy. I've got to move as quiet as possible, or he'll flush wild out of range, or run further up that fence line.
Jed, fetch!
I heard that shot. I can hear him talking to that lad now.
Oh boy, we could be in real trouble now. You want to get traded for a poodle?
Out. Pitch it up. Get the bird.
I like the lay of this field. It's got a dirt road on one side to block the birds and a slight valley with an old fence row in the middle with plenty of cover. The thing I don't like is they can run into the cover of the fence row from this field and into the next one. That's why John didn't select this field.
Ho, ho, ho! Here, here! Here! Over here, Mag. Here, 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 here! Here, over, 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 over.
I'll just weave my way slowly across this field, stop every so often to let the dog work and unsettle any bird that's holding tight. That tactic always works. Seems as long as you're moving, they think it's okay, but when you stop, they think you've spotted them, and up they come. I'm getting closer to that fence row, so I'll double back a bit and keep the dog in place. I like it's a blocker.
Over.
I'll get him on the downwind side of this cover to let his nose work.
Over.
And this looks about right. He's on a bird. I'm moving to cut the distance.
Catch it up. Boy, if that works, the score's tied. Good boy.
Good boy. Nice job. Yeah. That's a good bird, huh?
I've got to go until I reach that cornfield. I think I'll change course up here. That way I can push birds out of here into the cornfield. I'll probably come into the cornfield in a bit from the roadside and use the plowed field opposite it to hold the birds up.
Yo!
There's enough cover in this field to hide a dinosaur. Sometimes I can't even see the dog, and that's bad. I always like to be able to see him so I can read him. Now I can't see him at all. He must be on a point. I heard him over there last. Hey, there he is. Now, easy does it. close enough. It should be airborne by now. Man, I hate that. I should have known it. A bird in the center of this field holding like this, that probably would be a hen. It's tough on any dog. To them, the hen smells the same as the rooster. The only problem is they don't know the game laws. Hey, now that looks good. He's getting around to a likely spot for a rooster around that old willow. Bingo, he's locked up. Oh, brother, way to go, John. That is the quickest way to ruin a dog and buy dinner to boot.
You better get hot or you're walking home. Out.
I worked my way into that road. Could be that we pushed a bird that way, and it's likely he'll hold along the edge of it. He's on a weak scent, but it's getting hotter. That's all I need, a cripple.
Come on, hang in there. Get him, get him, get him, get him. All right, now he sees you. Okay, good job. Good boy.
I can see fresh tracks everywhere going and coming out of this old cornfield. Looks like chicken tracks. This is cut corn stalks with tumbleweed blown in and around them. Great. Good cover. I'll work this south edge, and then after I get to that end, I'll drive into it heading into the wind. The plowed field at the opposite end will act as a block.
Yo, check, yo.
The birds that are running ahead will hold right at that edge. I'll start weaving my way through it. There's a problem. That's an excellent escape route to the bordering field. So for the time being, I'll work tightly to that side to force birds away from it. There's one that got caught on his way out.
Jet fetch.
I might as well make a couple of zigzagging passes towards that dirt road. The road would be a better block if it were wider, but there's a chance I might get one to hold. The weather has definitely got a lot to do with the way they're holding today. Seems like the cloud cover and cold makes them seek cover. He's picked up a good scent. He's heading towards the high weeds. I've got to get in there. He's pushing you. He's getting close. Turn out the lights, the party's over.
this was a little disappointing, but I thought there would be a little more action in that cornfield than one bird. Oh well, I guess that's why they call it hunting. Nothing is for sure. I'll work up along this hill and start over to meet Mike. I don't mind buying dinner, but boy, I don't want to sit and listen to him rub it in and pay for it too.
I'm not too far from where I'm supposed to meet John. I guess it's about that time. Just one more bird in the bag. Too far.
Hey, I'm sorry I wasn't paying attention. So, sorry. Out.
I wonder what he could say if he could talk. There's John. Looks like three is all it's going to be for me.
There's Mike. I wonder how many he's got. Hell, if I know him, if he had his limit, he'd be doing a dance on that fence. Now the way it looks, two is going to be it. Oh, come on, Jed. Let's give it your best shot, boy. Yeah, come on. Easy does it now, boy. Easy, boy.
Jet, that's a good kill, huh? Good kid, too. All right, all right. I'll tell you what, let's go down there and see how Michael's doing, all right? I can smell those steaks cooking now. And I also think I can see some sweat pouring from his brow. Come on, boy, let's go. Hey, Michael, you see that? I think that about wraps it up. That's it.
What do you mean, that's it? Did you limit?
Come on, what do you mean, did I limit? What's the limit?
I don't know. I think it's three, but I lost count after three.
Three? Well, I got three. You say you have three?
Oh, no, I lost count.
Let me take a look at this. Let me take a look.
Now, this is an illegal search, John.
No. I'll tell you what I do. I count three, and that's all you got.
Three? Uh-huh. Oh, no, wait a minute. I had four. One must have fallen out. Gunner, did you see the one that fell out?
Count the ones you missed or dropped on a trail. Gunner didn't eat the bird. We're tied, my friend. Right now, we're tied.
Okay. Hey, look at that flock of geese.
Oh, yeah, that's a beautiful sight to behold, huh? Boy, that brings me back a few years, and you were teaching me even then, too. I was new at this game. Cold, freezing, a whole different kind of hunt.
Oh, come on, it wasn't that cold.
Well, it felt cold to me. I'll tell you what, though, they were just as beautiful as they are today, though.
Whew, Michael, you got me out here early enough. What time do you think you're gonna start coming in?
I don't know, John, that's hard to say. You know, I scouted this a couple of weeks ago. They were coming in here late in the afternoon. It was a full moon then, you know. So
late in the afternoon, what are we out here for at daybreak then?
Well, you see, as I said, it was a full moon at that time, and they began feeding, late in the afternoon, moving in off the lake, coming inland over the fields at that time. Uh-huh. Why, are you cold?
Just a little bit cold. Let me tell you, it's about 20 degrees.
I can run and get you a quilt or a pillow if you're uncomfortable.
Oh, come on, that's very funny. Look, what direction do you think they'll be coming in?
That's hard to say. You'll notice the wind is blowing downwind from us. They're going to hook in off the river and come into the decoys, into the wind. Geese almost always land into the wind.
Yeah, but the river's to the back of us back there.
Well, that's what I said. The wind is coming from the river this way.
I see. Okay. Okay, but how long is Magnum going to lay there quietly?
Oh, he'll lay there for a couple of hours, and then I'll get up and give him some exercise. Hey, listen, behind us.
Okay.
They're coming our way.
Yeah, they're going away.
Well, that's a no-go.
Boy, there was something they didn't like.
Why didn't you call more?
Well, you see, resting and feeding geese don't make a lot of noise.
Well, maybe it's because we're sitting too close to these decoys then, huh?
No, we're okay. This decoy spread is about 50 yards from the furthest point, so if they landed on the far end, they're at the end of our gun range. Here, why don't you practice with this for a while we're waiting?
Okay, good enough. Let me give her a try. Something like that?
Okay, that wasn't bad, but just remember to keep the point of it down. Skyward seems to be too loud. And I also add a little grunt to it to give the throaty sound of that big old honker. You might try keeping your hand at the end of it cupped, and you flare with the sound. So it's...
Okay, got it. You know, there's a lot of decoys out here today. Tell me something, why do we have so many different decoy patterns?
See, I've never seen geese or ducks sit in a C or J pattern. There's usually no rhyme or reason to the way the flocks are sitting at all.
Well, that's right. You see, decoy patterns are designed to attract birds, not mimic the way a particular species always group up to feed or rest.
Yeah, I've noticed that almost all your decoys are in the feeding position. Is this because you're trying to represent a feeding flock?
Well, yes and no. You see, from a distance, geese couldn't tell whether or not the necks of these decoys are feeding or tucked into a resting position. But they can, and they do, see all of the heads up. If you've ever seen a flock just before they fly, all the heads are up, which usually means an alarm. So if the majority of the heads are up in your decoys, from the air it looks as if all is not well.
Well, Mike, do you set your field up like this most of the time?
Oh, without exception, John. It's always worked the best for me, you see, because it represents a long line of feeding or resting geese.
They're not coming this way.
I'm sure not. But there's something I like up that river.
Man, struck out again. Michael, what's happening? What's wrong? That's the second time they've done that.
I don't know. Something's wrong. There's sure something here they don't like. I'll tell you what. I'm going to get Magnum and go back over towards the river. I'll leave you the call, okay?
All right.
See if I can find the direction in which they're going or where they're going anyway.
Okay, I'm not so sure I can do exactly what you showed me, but I'll give it a whirl.
You'll be okay. Just remember to keep the point of it down.
Okay, good enough. Good hunting.
Good boy.
Oh, Mike, good hunting, but let me ask you something. How do you know they're interested in something upriver?
Altitude, John. Altitude. You see, the higher flying birds are on a long flight. Lower flying birds are looking for a place to set down or feed or rest. Remember, keep your head down, keep the call tip down, because if you look up at them, they're going to see your smiling face.
All right, it's my first shot at it. Good hunting.
You bet. Come on, let's go.
I'll practice a little with this call while he's gone. Doesn't look like I'll be melting the barrel of this gun. When you hear a goose from the distance, it sounds sort of like a barking dog. But when they get closer, there's no mistaking that sound.
Get down here next to the willows. Good natural blind.
Right here. Come here, Magnum. Heel.
I'll put him a little down in front of me so he can see here. Better.
Come on, sit. Sit. Stay. We'll get the shot here.
Boy, this river's low. No doubt, ice jams have got something to do with it. Here comes a single. Looks like you'll be in range.
Pick him up.
Oh boy, get him. Come on, get him out of there. Good job. Come on, let's go. Pick it up. Let's
Nice goose, huh?
Well, that dirty son of a gun. Here I sit, hands numb, feet numb, rear end numb, guarding a flock of plastic fakes while he shoots geese. Somewhere there's a flock with my name on it. I just don't know exactly where. Beginning to put two and two together. If Mike thought those decoys were the best bet, well, he would have stayed here. I'll give it another 15 minutes, and he's going to have company on that river. But you never know. There could be a bunch on the way that aren't following the river.
Job. Looks like you did everything right. You froze. You let him get into gun range.
Yeah, you're right, Michael, but that's what great goose hunting's all about, man. Got my limit. And I'll tell you what, I even tried using a call once. It worked just like a charm.
Well, I didn't hear it, John, but I'll tell you, you did something right. Listen, I got one more bird to go, so let's rearrange that outside spread.
Wait, I heard you say we. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Considering the freeze-out routine, I see I've got my limit. So I'm going to offer you a whole lot of support, but I'm going to do it from the vehicle where it's nice and warm, you know, a good heater, some sandwiches, some coffee, and I'll tell you what, I'll be rooting for you right from there.
John, you're getting pretty good with that call. You could sit out here and help me call him.
Michael, I'll give you a hand with that call, but from a warm vehicle.
I hope that heater breaks.
Hey, how long was it before you got that last bird? I'll tell you what, it must have been at least 3-4 hours. I enjoyed a great nap.
No, try 2 hours.
Oh.
And you should have seen it. I mean, I got on this call. I mean, I saw one single way out over the flock, right?
And I looked up, I hit that call and called him, and I worked him right down over the decoys, and he wasn't 5 feet off the deck.
Come on, here. Here, right about here. Let's go.
Come here. Come on, sit. Lay down. Lay down. You stay.
What do you want, a quilt?
Stay. All right, you stay.
Stay. See if I can get you something. This is going to be a little easier on you here.
You stay.
Fetch it out. Here.
Uh-huh. So you think you're eating prime rib now?
Well, there's no doubt about that.
Oh, come on, look. Take a look ahead here. We got 200 yards right along this fence line before we get back to the vehicle. Let's call the game right from there.
Okay. But I'll tell you, I think you better put your dog on a leash.
I'll tell you what. You take care of that lab. I'll take care of my pointer. The race is on.
Okay, let's go. Heel. Out. Hey, whoa, here, over. Go on.
Oh, Mike, look at this. How about prime rib? Just on a point.
Ouch. Get up. Hey, I'll tell you what, the party's not over yet.
I'm not going to tell you who finally won the bet, but his initial is J, and so's his dog's.
Oh, that's not the truth. It's the initial M and G, as in Mike and Gunner.
Okay, well, we'll settle this next weekend. Let's give you the gun for a moment and let you hunt. Remember, in hunting an uncut cornfield, the drive is the most productive method. But for safety reasons, it must be well planned. The drivers should move slowly at an even pace abreast of each other. The blockers are critical to holding the birds up and should always remain in position for safety and effectiveness.
Bird up.
Hey, nice shot.
Yeah, not bad. When hunting open fields, you're going to be most effective with a trained dog. Remember, pheasants are real runners. So the faster you move, the faster and farther they'll run. Whether hunting with a pointing or flushing dog, move slowly and let him work. Also, remember that edges and the ends of fields are the more likely spots for holding birds. Here you go. All right, nice shot.
Are you going to bet with this guy?
I don't think so. Let's go to the geese.
Okay. When hunting geese from a blind, always take a quilt and pillow.
Oh, yeah, real funny, wise guy.
All right. Remember, your decoy spread should have most of the heads down in the feeding position. Too many heads up represents an alarmed flock and spells warning to approaching birds. A dog isn't necessary here, only a matter of preference. In calling, don't stick your head out of the blind and point the call skyward, just through the small opening in the lid, and only at curious birds. When they set their wings and start down, lay off the call. Remember, feeding geese give a chuckling sound, and it's relatively quiet, so there's not a lot of noise. Don't forget to lead them. They're big birds. Okay, take them. All right. John, will you go get those birds? Or are you going to the truck to eat my lunch?
Speaking of lunch, who made those sandwiches?
You didn't have to eat them.
What was I supposed to do? Go to a restaurant?